Hello everyone, this is Lincoln, the channel for Higher Self. Welcome to the Satsang with the Self video series. In these Satsang videos, I bring through information and energies from the Higher Self consciousness. We all exist within one field of unified intelligence, energy, and consciousness. We can learn to transcend our own personal experience to connect more deeply into this reality. This is what I display in these Higher Self videos. In today's video, I will allow this greater universal consciousness to communicate with you. These videos offer support, guidance, and transformational energies to help you on your spiritual path of personal awakening and transformation. Please enjoy today's video. Dear ones, everything right here and right now is part of your universe. It is the reality and the only reality you know. Close your eyes and bring your awareness down to the center of your chest. You have existing at the center a doorway of love and light. We call this doorway the spiritual heart. Feel your heart. Focus here. As you bring your awareness from head to heart, you will notice peace increases. Your body becomes relaxed and releases the stress and tension it holds. Your emotions gradually slow, quiet, and harmonize. You create a state of inner balance between your emotional energies, your numerous chakras, and your male and female channels. Feel this transformation. Become aware. Simple power this one practice has. As you continue to focus upon your spiritual heart, your thoughts become less and less. Peace enters into your mind and a lucid clarity begins to dawn. You will realize that you are not the thinking mind. You are not the personality which has these thoughts. You are beyond it. You are the consciousness that is eternal. Exist in this state of silent mind, open heart, and freedom. Feel your heart center. Allow all parts of you to come into balance. Allow transcendence to take effect. Good. We want you, dear ones, to meditate upon the spiritual heart each and every day. The more you practice, the more you'll harmonize all parts of your created self, and the easier it will be to transcend them, to understand and explore your spiritual reality. Realize, dear ones, that you are at the center of your universe, and all that you create, all that you desire, all that you allow in through yourself becomes your reality. You are God co-creating life. Your perceptual reality is all you'll ever know. So begin to understand it. Begin to explore it. Begin to master it. You, dear ones, have been conditioned while living on this earth to focus upon work, to focus upon possessions and property, to focus on income and reputation, fame and praise. You've been taught to focus upon the particulars and to ignore the greatest question of all. What is this? What is this moment? We often live our lives taking for granted the simple reality that we experience as ourselves. We have seemed to have forgotten the great mystery in which we live, and we create our experience looking at the particulars, thinking of the forms, acting upon the forms, and never at all questioning, who am I at the center of the universe, and what is this universe? What is this reality? Those who have asked such questions and those who have worked to find the answers achieved their transcendence. They found awakening, enlightenment, self-realization. It was not a difficult road. It was simply a road that must be traveled. You have equal time as any other ascended master. You have equal energy as anyone else who's walked the path to enlightenment. You are given the same opportunities as everyone else. How you choose to spend your time and energy, that is your freedom, and that determines what your reality will be. It is that simple. Many of you believe you cannot. You're unable to. Many of you think there's not enough time, there's not enough energy, I'm not strong enough. Many of you hold these beliefs and do not practice. Instead, you focus your mind on other thoughts. Instead, you focus your energies and your time on other activities. Of course, you will not grow as quickly as you can if you do not work towards this awakening. You are at the center of the universe. You always have been, and you always will be. All you have known and all you will ever know is your perceptual reality. Understand it. Understand who you are as this field of consciousness, as this flow of creative power, as this. Now, dear ones, today's video teaching is going to help you understand desires. You are the flow of creative energy. You are the flow, dear ones. That is your reality. You are consciousness. You are intelligence. and you are energy. You are aware, you know your experience, and you are creating your experience. We can say that God does this through us. It is our natural state. We are this. Our own creative power enters as we decide to use these three states. How are you using your perception? What are you focusing your awareness upon? Perhaps it is the world outside of you. Perhaps it is your physical body. Perhaps it is your emotional body. Perhaps it is your mind. Perhaps it is another dimension beyond the physical. Perhaps it is the silence or even awareness itself. You are God's created awareness, and your choice is how you want to behave or perform as this awareness. Your personal will uses this awareness. The same holds true with knowing. You have God's knowing. You are aware, and you know you exist. You do not choose to end your existence, but you may choose what to focus your knowledge upon. Just like you focus your awareness on isolated forms or dimensions, you focus your knowledge on isolated forms or dimensions. Finally, we are creative energy. We are creating. We cannot stop this. But what we can choose is the actions we take. We can choose how the creative energy flows. We can increase it or decrease it. We can move it here or there. We can direct it towards objects, emotions, thoughts, or silence. And so you are that free will being. You do not create your awareness, you do not create your state of knowing, and you do not create your energy. You simply determine how you want to use them. With this understanding, we can see that it is our desires, our intentions, that are the primary factor we have in our lives. You cannot control how the world responds to you. You cannot remove yourself from experience, but you can decide how you shape your reality. We begin with desires, dear one, because desires underlay the foundation of reality. Your desires determine how you modify your awareness, how you modify your knowing, and how you modify your energy's expression. Often in our lives, we are living on secondary or tertiary levels of desire. Desire is not just what we want to do in life. Desire is also how we are shaping our reality. You may have a thought that you are not good enough, but you do not desire to think this. You desire to be good enough. You want to feel good enough. And so you work. You work at self-improvement. You work at self-healing and transformation. You create growth. Your conscious desire is to become good enough. But your conscious desire is only working as a response to a belief you already have within you. And so subconsciously, you have a desire to uphold this counterproductive belief. Your subconscious mind is believing you're not good enough, so your conscious mind is believing you want to be good enough. Can you understand this? Most of our motivation to create anything is stemming from an equal and opposite belief. We can look at the laws of physics and we can see that this point of knowledge has already been proven. All forces will have an equal and opposite force. All forces in the physical have been shown to have an equal and opposite force. The same holds true with emotions and thoughts. This is the yin and yang balance. These are the male and female creative powers. They are equal and opposite, and they fluctuate. Sometimes there is one expressing, sometimes there's the other expressing, and on they're always acting against each other. They cannot exist in a total state of balance, or else creation would stop. There must be some imbalance so that creation can continue to move. And so there is an equal and opposite, but it may not be fully expressing as active. It may be potential. And so, dear ones, looking at your own personal lives, you yourself hold beliefs. Beliefs about what you want to do. Beliefs about who you want to become. And you spend your time acting upon these. As long as you choose to act upon them, you are responding to that which you hold inside yourself already. Your past, your subconscious, your family environment, your social environment has conditioned you to believe something about yourself. It is the I am statement. I am not good enough. Because the world told me I am not good enough. My parents did not give me the love or support or appreciation I desired as a child, so I formed an idea that I'm not good enough. And now as an adult, I'm trying to break this idea. I'm trying to become good enough. I'm trying to feel loved within myself. I'm trying to be successful within myself. See this dynamic interaction. This is important. For you will understand the dynamic nature of opposites and how they continue to create all of reality. We are not judging these forces as bad or wrong. We are simply saying that the two forces must exist for change to be present, for the universe of forms to even express itself. And so they are perfect. They are perfect. Within that statement, we also have our freedom. Our freedom to choose, our freedom to be in this dynamic interplay, and our freedom to transcend it. We can sit here and we can say with easy and clear words that it can be transcended. See the belief that is driving your conscious desires. Do not feel that your conscious desire will overpower the belief. You must look at the deeper belief. And you must disassemble that. You must see it, understand it, and let it go. You cannot live from a reactionary position and think that you will heal the core. You must go to the core beliefs, examine them, understand why you were formed in that way, how the world shaped you, and then step into your conscious empowerment at that depth and transform it. So often our actions are in response to how we feel deep inside, and many times we're not aware of how we feel and what we believe at that depth. We must look at how we feel and how we think, those core beliefs. The evidence is in your emotion. Go to the root, find the beliefs, the deep beliefs in your mind, and then knowing that you are eternal creative spirit, that you are not bound by what you thought as a child, that you are free to act on what you know as a spiritually aware adult. From that place, reprogram. We will lead you now in this practice. Close your eyes and feel your spiritual heart. Feel the love and the peace you have within you. Feel your heart going deeper within and expanding larger without. You are entering into states of God consciousness as your heart center is realized. Feel the blissful love that flows through you from your heart. Feel God's gift of life, God's gift of creative energy. Recognize that you are awareness, knowledge of what is, and the power to create this. And just be this state. Just be this simple reality. First, we connect to God within, to the core of our source consciousness, to that place of awareness, knowing, and power. We connect to be this, to remember who we are. We connect to awaken and live as our truth. When you exist at this depth, there are no problems, there is only peace. You feel yourself in bliss. You feel the connection between all of life and the source energy that brings life into being. There are no more questions. There are no more desires. Everything is known in its perfection. And you are this, such love, such power, such peace. The world's gifts cannot compare to who you already are. If you, dear ones, hold to this state and live here always, purification will unfold naturally. But you must hold to this state and not go out. Not go out to seek the forms. Do not let your mind slip from this place of stillness. Do not let your heart fade away as the other desires of the external world come into you. Hold to your depth, and that is the only practice you would need to perform. Live in the world, allowing the senses to come into you, but you not going out to get them. You will need to eat, you will need to work. Let the world come into you to guide you. Do not add onto it. Use your personal will to stay held to source consciousness. To stay held to the depth of your heart. And just go on living, worshiping God in every moment, feeling your heart as a sign of devotion, as true devotion to that which is. For those of us who are still working to purify the mind and have difficulty staying in the heart center, we offer you the following technique. First, connect. Always connect, for that is where we find our power. That is where we find our peace. That is where we find ourselves. The thoughts you hear that come from your past, they are not you. They are the voice of your memory. You are the present moment awareness. You are the present moment knowledge. You are the present moment power. It is your past and the personality created from memories that holds the desires and the beliefs about your being. I am not good enough is a belief we often feel because we live in a society based upon performance. You must do. You must meet a standard. You must meet an expectation. And this is a goal placed upon you that you are forced into. You are forced to go to school, forced to take their tests, forced to repeat their knowledge. Your mind is forced to pre-programmed with what they tell you is truth. Yes, we must have some schooling and some knowledge to be effective in this world as a co-created society. But often along with our education comes numerous ways of programming the personality, such as believing you must be a slave, so to speak, that you must do what you're told, that you cannot think freely, that you cannot act freely. We often form a belief that we are not good enough, that we are not worthy of love, that we must somehow act, meet another's approval, and then receive love. But this is conditional energy. It is not true love. It is not the unconditional quality of bliss that comes from God and God-realized human beings. What we often seek is a limited frequency. Call it happiness, because there's a higher vibration from where we normally stand. But happiness beyond happiness, that is the bliss. The highest states of love, the perfection and the oneness in which achievement no longer exists as a thought, desire, or concern. And so you have these beliefs within you. I am not good enough. And that motivates you to seek love from other people, to find yourself in relationship. With anything. Relationship with another person, relationship with an article of clothing, relationship with a job title, relationship with a home or property. Some of you, many of you watching these videos, have formed relationships with information to make yourself feel good enough. Loved, accepted by your own minds. The core belief that can drive any of these behaviors, the premise with which we start, is I am not good enough. And this is what must be broken down. When you break the core belief, all the following beliefs and actions will be broken as well. To break the core belief, we must go to our core and we must redefine who we are. The world told us that we are not good enough. You must define yourself, not the world. The world told you, I am not good enough, and you believed it. You upheld it. Your experience created that knowledge. God tells you, you are perfect. You are perfect in every moment when you align with God's truth. When you align with the world's truth, you become all of these different qualities. You become not good enough. You become unloved. You become incomplete. Understand that you are choosing where to focus your awareness, where to focus your knowing, where to focus your energy. You can focus and live upon God's reality, or you can focus and live upon society's reality. You are being asked to question how you define yourself, where you focus, and how the energy of life moves through you. Open your spiritual heart. Go within. Truly desire to know God, and you will discover how God defines you. You will feel that blissful love that flows through you unconditionally. You will be that peaceful, open awareness. And you will realize you can just be without thought or action, without expectation. You can just be as consciousness. You can just be as yourself. You can be and there will be peace, and you can be and there will be love. And that which you are is unconditioned. It is not based upon what's happening around you in the world. It's not based upon the astral dimension or emotion. It's not based upon thought or knowledge or understanding. Your natural state beyond these conditioned universes is perfect peace as awareness. Perfect love. As creative energy and the knowledge that I am. You must experience this depth to truly know this truth and to experience the transformation that then happens in your mind's ideas. So make this your primary practice, truly. The world has shown you who it wants you to be. It's conditioned you based upon the reality it gave you. The world did not speak to you and tell you you are this way. The world gave you an experience, and that created these core beliefs about you. So simply telling yourself you are God's love, that's not going to be enough. You must reach the experience of being God's love. That is going to reshape these core beliefs. You must strive to know God. You must work. How you use your time and how you use your energy creates your reality. Rarely do we question, who am I and what is this? Rarely do we look beyond the forms and understand the perceptual reality that we are all having. There is no substitute for seeking God. There is no substitute. Yes, you can create thoughts of affirmation, and yes, these will be new experiences in the world that reshape your core beliefs about yourself, but you are still defining yourself by the world. We want you to define yourself by God. That is the greatest transformation you can create. That is where you must strive. Level 1, for those who are ready, is to hold onto this place of God realization and always stay in it. Level two, for those who are not quite as ready, are to reach that depth in meditation by holding to your heart and entering into these states periodically. Number three is what we will discuss now, and that is using the power of your thought. As we said, you can create affirmation, re-informing yourself of what you know to be your truth. This will lead you closer to level two, which will lead you closer to level one. We can tell ourselves that we are loved by God, and we can tune into that energy and feel it. We can tell ourselves that we are perfect. We can use our conscious mind to reprogram the beliefs of not being good enough. We can tell ourselves a new life story, and this will change our personality. Understand, dear one, that the world outside of you told you who you are. Your parents may have told you such words. They may have acted towards you in such ways. Your family, friends, past lovers, employers, educators, all of these people, all of your peers, may have formed your identity. You must form it for yourself now, based upon what you know, based upon what you believe, what you want to experience. Realize, dear ones, that our personality is formed by the world around us, and these are all relative truths. They are the beliefs of other people, and so your own beliefs, your own relative truths, hold a similar power. Beyond these beliefs is the truth, the knowledge of God. That holds more transformative power. But do not think that your own beliefs are powerless. Your own beliefs have equal power to every word spoken to you by any other person. In fact, you have more power because you are within yourself and you are the creator of your reality. You must know that every belief, even if it seems untrue right now, has the power to become your relative truth. That is how you were formed and shaped by the world. And so, go into that state of your spiritual heart. Try to feel God. Try to realize your eternal self. And then in that state of deep connection and silence, in that state of expanded consciousness, tell yourself who you are. I am love. 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 Tell yourself your reality. What do you want it to be? What do you know it is? When you speak these affirmations, create it with the I am. This will redefine you. As you speak those words, feel the associated emotion. It may not seem like it's changing much, but continue to do it. The more you program yourself, the more it's going to break through old beliefs and patterns. You will experience emotional heights as you create these energies directly. You will experience the release of old emotions. You may cry as old pains get removed. You may cry as you elevate to higher states. Trust the process. You're replacing the beliefs that others have told you with the beliefs that you know inside. You, dear ones, can use many statements. I am perfect just the way I am. I am a successful creator. God loves me. The universe loves me. I am free to follow my heart. I am always supported by God. Peace is my natural state. I am peace. I am beautiful. I am healthy. I know I am powerful. I believe in my power. Love is all around me. Love is all that I am. I am love. You, dear ones, can go within your mind and enter new ideas. They may be beliefs, but they will turn into truths. To act in the world, to try to prove to yourself that you are worthy, is to only act in response of an idea of first being unworthy. When you act upon an idea, you affirm its position and its hold within you. You can look to the world and you can see many great manifestors who still are acting upon beliefs of low self-worth, a lack of love, a lack of creative power. There are men and women who have reached the heights of material success. They have manifested from rags to riches, from dirt shacks to imperial palaces, and deep inside they still believe that they are not loved, that they are not good enough, You cannot expect the outside world to reprogram your inner self. The outer is reflected. The inner creates the reflection. Go within your mind. That is where the program is written. Enter into that silence. Connect with the power of your heart. Be that awareness, knowing and energy, and create a new sense of your personal self as a human being. Define yourself by the principles of God, not the principles of the world. Rewrite your human script. Create the life your heart wants to live. For those who are there, for those who are ready, this is your path, a reality based upon God's consciousness and not the world's, not the confusion of man. Feel your heart. Love God. Devote yourself to this eternal reality. And when the world pulls you in, smile. Smile at this pattern. Do not judge. Do not be upset or angered. Do not feel weak or depressed. Smile. Laugh at yourself and feel your heart and celebrate the journey. You are God's reality. Whether you live under the world's definitions or live under your own, you are still God's reality. And you are bliss. And you are peace. You are love and perfection. Many blessings, much love. Namaste.